In my undervolting guide, I advised you on a sweet range of 825-900 mV to preserve most of your graphics card performance. But if you were to set the minimum allowed voltage instead, what would it be its impact on temperature, power consumption, and performance? You'll soon find out. First thing first, you must determine that minimum voltage. Open a VVF curve editor, select all VVF points after the straight line and bring them down below it. Then pick the last point, bring it up at 1000 MHz and hit apply. Finally, click on boost lock and note the millivolts. They indeed represent the minimum voltage allowed by the VGA BIOS. In my case, it's 744 millivolts. The second step is to discover the maximum stable frequency at this voltage. Take your tweaked curve and, for each voltage, subtract 15 MHz from the next frequency until you reach your lowest. Then, test that VF combo via OCCT10 for a full hour, no less. If it's stable, increase the frequency by one step until it fails. If it's not, decrease the frequency by one step until it succeeds. In my case, 1605 MHz is the winner. The third step is to benchmark the stable VF combo via 3DMark x Extreme and Port Royal. Repeat each test no less than 3 times. Write down all these data, compute their averages, and copy-paste them beside those of the other 5 conditions. Now you can finally compare them all. Let's begin with my temperatures. Moving from stock condition to UV900, the temp drops by about 4 degrees in x SPI and 8 degrees in Port Royal. From UV900 to UV744, the temp drops by about 11 and 10 degrees respectively. This means a decrease of approximately 1.8 degrees for every negative 25 millivolts. Then the power consumptions. Going from stock condition to UV900, the draw drops by about 20 watts in x SPI and 50 watts in Port Royal. From UV900 to UV744, the draw drops by about 80 and 68 watts respectively. This means a decrease of approx 12.4 watts for every negative 25 millivolts. Now, you're perhaps thinking, this is all fun and games until you tell me about performance. Sure, let's do it. Moving from stock condition to UV900, the performance increases by almost 1% in x SPI and decreases by almost 1% in Port Royal. Crazy, right? From UV900 to UV744, the performance drops by just 14.5% in both benchmarks. This means a reduction of approx 2.4% for every negative 25 millivolts. Finally, let's talk about efficiency. Since 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second, and 1 FPS is equal to, well, 1 frame per second, it makes perfect sense to measure efficiency in joules per frame. Going from stock condition to UV900, it improves by 0.55 JPF in x SPI and by 1.23 JPF in Port Royal. From UV900 to UV744, it improves by 1.37 and 1.23 JPF respectively. This represents a rise in efficiency of around 0.22 joules per frame for every negative 25 millivolts. To sum up, if I decided to set my 3070 at 744 millivolts and 1605 MHz, on average it would perform about 15% worse than at stock and consume around 130 watts. In a nutshell, its performance would be on par with a 3060 Ti, and its power draw with a 1660 Super. All of these at a quite lukewarm temperature. That's what you might achieve too with the magic science of undervolting. Farewell for now.